The human potential for evolution is limitless. Just a few short centuries ago, humans lived in groups as a means of protecting themselves from bigger, more dangerous animals in their vicinity. Fast forward to present day, and we've become the masters of planet Earth. So what happens next? Do we hang up our boots and call it a day? Of course not. We do not get this far by relenting in our thirst for progress, and we certainly won't stop just when we finally unlock the ability to control and augment not only the world around us, but our physical forms as well. Now before we continue, I'd like you all to know I make new videos every week on Thursdays and Sundays, so please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content. It is widely accepted that humanity is rapidly approaching the upper limits of our mastery of the very technology we create. This is why we build machines to handle tasks our fragile minds and bodies are incapable of managing on their own. A good example of this is a computer. If the average human mind could store and process the same amount of data as a modern computer, those smart devices would quickly become obsolete for obvious reasons. Transhumanism, therefore, is the quest to improve the human condition through the use of advanced technologies. Although it sounds like a purely fictional concept, humanity already began taking steps towards its transhumanist future almost a decade ago. From prosthetics that could replace entire limbs, to synthetic organs which perform just as well or even better than the ones we were born with. This video is the first of a two-part series where we will discuss the inorganic and cybernetic technologies that could aid humanity in its quest for transcendence. A short look at the human anatomy reveals a system that was designed to thrive on the Earth's surface and nowhere else. This is why we need diving suits and oxygen tanks to manage any sort of sustained presence underwater, or a pressurized suit with radiation shielding to survive the harshness of space. The fusion of our bodies with biomechatronic parts will be the key to thriving in an environment such as the ones I've mentioned. For example, if a group of people were to decide sometime in the future that they wanted to live underwater for whatever reason, it could mean something as simple as switching out their lungs and replacing them with cybernetic gills. There would no longer be a need to carry bulky oxygen tanks or live in cramped submersibles. And several projects are being carried out today which could one day allow a human live among fishes without the fear of drowning. Beyond something as drastic as modifications to allow us survive in otherwise hostile environments, cybernetics could serve to improve on our already existing abilities. Bionic eyes could replace our regular old ones, giving us a range of visual capabilities, from microscopic to full spectral vision. This would allow us to see in total darkness, through walls, or even spot a needle in a haystack from over 300 meters away. Okay, I may have gone overboard with that last one, but everything else would be entirely possible. Considering our eyes are our most relied upon sense, it's simply a matter of time until sufficiently advanced retinal prosthetics are created which are superior to what evolution gave to us. The biggest challenge may not even be about building superior bionic eyes, but remodeling the visual cortex so that it can process the increased data and relay it to the rest of the brain in such a way that it is not overwhelmed. We've all heard about electric eels and catfishes which are able to generate over 500 volts of electricity through specialized electric organs in their bodies. This natural process is known as electrogenesis. In a way, we humans are also electrogenic, as each of our brain cells produces about 70 millivolts of electric potential, while our muscle cells produce about 95 millivolts. Now, for a human to achieve or even surpass the electric potential of these mysterious aquatic animals, we would need to implant specialized cybernetic electric organs within our bodies. This cybernetic organ would be able to tap electricity from the natural chemical processes which occur in our muscles and store that energy until the host of that organ chooses to discharge it. It's important to note that this process won't make anyone shoot intense jolts of electricity from their hands, as air requires over 3 million volts of electricity just to cover the distance of 1 meter. But it would sure as hell make you a living electroshock weapon for anyone who dares to come close enough. Although we heal from minor injuries relatively quickly, we can do little but watch in envy as other animals in nature are able to grow lost appendages in mere days. The good news is we may not need to be green for much longer. A team at Ohio State University developed a technology capable of regrowing damaged organs and healing serious wounds with the single touch of a penny-sized pad. The device uses nanochips to reprogram skin cells, which then generate any type of cell necessary for medical treatment. This gives us a hint of a future where super nanobots swimming in our blood vessels would patch up otherwise fatal injuries at neck-breaking speeds and make us impervious to virtually all diseases. Take that, Mr. Salamander. Our physical strength is yet another interesting area that our technology could drastically improve. And the funny thing is, the tech needed to achieve superhuman strength has already been invented. Early in 2006, scientists at the University of Texas developed artificial muscles 100 times stronger than our own, powered by alcohol and hydrogen. A weightlifter whose natural muscles were replaced with these synthetic polymer muscles would be able to lift over 30 tons. That's Superman territory right there. Just don't go around wearing your underwear over your costume though, please. Now, if you're as strong as Superman, you're probably gonna need his flying ability to get around. No self-respecting superhero will be caught in traffic during rush hour on his way to save a cat from a tree. Today, wingsuits allow adrenaline junkies to glide in the air like birds simply by spreading their arms. While many hold the opinion that wingsuits only permit a controlled fall, inventions like jet-powered wingsuits currently allow experienced divers soar through the air for minutes at a time. It's not too crazy to believe these winged contraptions will be available to regular people in the future, at which point the only problem left will be dodging each other while flying to work. At the very extremes of our transhumanist undertaking, we humans could forego our organic bodies altogether, opting for a more durable cybernetic vessel, or simply digitizing our consciousness, which would allow us to live forever. Well, technically. Now, some may argue at this point that anyone who's gone this far can no longer be termed as a human, but do we really know what it truly means to be human? Our interpretation of what constitutes humanity is vague at best, and opinions vary wildly amongst experts. The fact of the matter is that transhumanism is just a modern term for an age-old phenomenon. The truth is we've been augmenting our humanity since the dawn of our existence, and will only continue to do so as our mastery of technology escalates, perhaps towards one day achieving the singularity.